All right, everybody. Hey, it's my lucky day. I'm in the backyard barbecue right now with my two best friends, Chef Johnny Granata from the Post Office Cafe.
Excellent.
And the muscle here.
Yeah, that's me. TV Maitre D, Joe Zito. And I said, whatever Jimmy's wearing, I'm wearing. That's how we're rolling this morning. And that's what we're doing.
Baby
good morning,
blue,
sir.
you can't beat that.
And the Daily Double.
Although I forgot the sunglasses.
And Jimmy, what's today's Daily Double? You're thinking, who are these two guys? For $200, you know? Come on.
I know I'm not going to get hurt back here. And today, we're making some seafood. As a matter of fact, we're making some swordfish.
Swordfish.
And you told me, Livornese.
Livornese.
Oh, you
now,
got it.
Now, Joe, tell me about Livornese.
Livornese, if you're at home going, he's going to put liver on swordfish. No, he's not going. It's from Livorno, which is near Tuscany.
A coastal town, I'm told.
It's where this beautiful sauce originated, and the chef will tell you about all these gorgeous, fresh summertime ingredients.
Now, it's my perfect day. I understand he doesn't like seafood. No. I love it.
He doesn't like us either, but that never stops us.
I thought it was us, not the swordfish. Yeah.
So anyway. What are we making? What do we need? What do we need to tell people to go out and buy? First of all,
we need the star of the show. We need some beautiful swordfish, all right?
Okay.
This time of year, it's pretty much in abundance, so...
You want
to look for some nice fresh swordfish or any fish that, you know, any fish that you could get, like somebody catches it off the boat, brings it to you. This sauce will go with it.
Okay. How about those ingredients?
All right. We got some nice heirloom tomatoes. Right now, all the cherry tomatoes, all the tomatoes on the vines are all coming out in Rhode Island. You know, so what we did was we put some different types together just for some color, some shallots
nice
over
variety.
There. Yeah. Some shallots, some fresh basil, capers, and olives. We're using a Gaeta olive from the Gaeta region of Italy. You could use Kalamata, you could use any olive that you like.
Okay.
Pit them though, because you don't want to be chewing on them.
Mm-hmm. Or choke, for God's sake.
Yeah, absolutely.
Especially not the family. Yeah. A real good olive oil, garlic, and I put a little chili paste in it for a little zip.
Little zip.
Yep. This is very easy. We're gonna bake all this in the grill in a foil container. We're just going to throw it in the foil, wrap
some
it up.
Way to do it.
All right, just don't throw me in there, okay?
No.
We're going to give you a Lovino at the end, too, so everything's good over here.
That's right, I'm here for the wine. Once again, Joe and John, we're having fun here at the backyard barbecue, and we'll let you know what we're doing a little bit later. Thank you very much.
Side where Jimmy is grilling with Joe and John.
Thanks, Michaela. Once again, I'm here with my new best friends, John and Joe.
Hello.
Smelling great out here. So where are we right now in the process?
All right. So I took aluminum foil and I put it in a bowl.
Okay.
And I put the heirloom tomatoes.
Oh, they smell the basil already.
You're going to just tear this basil up and throw it in there. All right? There's no rhyme or reason to this.
Very simple backyard recipe, you know. You want to enjoy your friends, your family, your guests, and this is not going to go crazy with prep.
Keep it simple.
Oh, yeah.
Kiss. Shallot. That's how you remember
it. That's the other half. Absolutely.
My friend, he said, keep it simple, stupid.
Yeah, that's it. That's us.
Olives, capers, fantastic.
Salt.
Yes, sir.
Pepper.
Jimmy, this is a melange of flavors.
You know, when you buy a fish, here's my biggest problem.
Yeah.
I never know, okay, you bring it home from the store, how long do you need before you throw it out?
There's our expert.
Well,
the smell test or what?
You should buy the fish and cook it that day.
Okay.
You should never wait a couple of days.
I've made that mistake, unfortunately.
Yeah, we don't want to do that.
So we've opened the oven.
Yeah, but also keep it in your glove compartment because I heard that you did that. That's not good.
That's
either,
not a good thing.
Yeah, that's probably the problem.
So we placed it right on the grill. I got this grill up to about 500 degrees. It went down just a bit, but we're going to put it right on the grill. If you have coals or fire, you want to put it just off from the center of the fire.
Okay.
So the next step is when we come back, I'm gonna grill these up. And hopefully everything will be ready at the same time. We're just going to olive oil these. And we're going to season them up nice.
If it's not ready at the same time, we'll just go into the next show and we'll go off at 10:30.
We'll bring you can't get deal. Enough of these boys.
No, there's up. They love us. Yeah.
All right, I'm still alive. We'll be back. We're going to find out how to finish up the swordfish Livornese. You're watching The Rhode Show, and we're back here at the backyard barbecue.
Back outside once again. We've got grilled swordfish on the menu. Now I'm surrounded by three guys. Usually I come out here and it's just Joe and John, but now it's Joe, John, and Jimmy.
Yeah, we call it Beauty and the Beasts. That's how we do it.
The triple J's, right?
J's.
Here we go. All right,
so we got some beautiful swordfish. So in the last segment, what I did was I made a foil tent, basically.
Mm-hmm.
I put all the ingredients that I had out here in the foil tent to roast on the grill at the same time as I was going to cook the swordfish. Okay, so when we open up, we get the swordfish.
Look at those grill marks.
Yeah, that's the best part.
Get the swordfish going. It's actually perfect right now. So basically what you do is you season up the swordfish, right? A little olive oil, salt and pepper. Don't go crazy with anything.
Very simple.
Yeah.
Right? Good olive oil, salt and pepper. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna slide this out. And you see that things are starting to come together in there as a sauce.
And Michaela, Jimmy, like I was saying, if you're going to do this and you want to entertain your guests and you want to have a good time, this was the simplest way.
Right.
He put that in a bowl
with
the tinfoil and threw those fresh ingredients in.
You can still talk to your guests. You can come to the grill. It'll take you like 5 minutes to do this.
I notice you're touching that swordfish. Should it feel a certain way to know that it's done?
I'm going to show you. So you're going to bring the swordfish. You see how you still see juices running on it?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's what you want. And at the same time, when you take the tong, you're going to be able to go through it easy. See? Feel
okay.
it. You're going to be able to just go right in it. There'll be like very little
very
resistance.
Light.
Right?
Will has no idea what he's missing.
No.
Well, he may.
He may. What's he thinking?
So,
Will, you're going to change your mind, maybe.
I want to show you. This sauce becomes...
Livornese sauce, Jimmy.
It becomes a sauce very quickly. And when you open up the tent, there's your sauce. Okay.
Isn't that
the
pretty?
The colors, the smells coming from there.
Here's the problem, though. How are we going to get out of there? We're just going to pull it over.
We're going to do...
What are we going to do, Joe?
What? No, help.
This guy knows what to do.
Right. What? So we're just going to pour it.
Oh, nice.
All right? We're going to take the tent.
You need
the
tongs, though?
There.
No. You made this really easy, and even easy cleanup.
Look at that.
You got that right?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Always thinking,
look
Michaela.
At that. How pretty is that?
I'm always thinking of ways to avoid washing dishes.
A little fresh basil.
Right, all you want to avoid washing dishes, you just give everybody a fork and you sit around and eat it.
Yum.
Voila. Right? Beautiful.
Look at that. You got the broth, you got the swordfish, you got the heirloom tomatoes with the colors.
If you had some bread, you could sop that up.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
that's
seriously, this was
sop
an easy
right
dish
up.
That really literally
have a little taste of the sauce.
Prep.
Okay.
There's one for you, sir.
Thank you.
While we do that, you got to pair this with a nice beverage.
Yes, and here's what I've done. Generally, we would have, you see swordfish and you want a white wine. Well, it's summer. Mm-hmm. And summertime, you can never go wrong with an Italian Pinot Grigio. Clean, crisp, delicious, will not offend anything, and yet it will stand up to all of the wonderful flavors here, which even though you see all the symphony of flavors here, mm-hmm. it's still light. It's not overbearing. It's not a puttanesca sauce. It's not a Fra Diavolo sauce, but it's still flavorful.
It really
this is.
This
is crisp Pinot Grigio. It is from Venice. It's a Leonardo Locascio selection, and he picks only the best. And here's the best thing about this. This will stand up to any Pinot Grigio you know, the Santa Margaritas, all of them, and it's $9.99 at Chris
Gasparo's. That's my cousin Lenny.
You can't beat that.
Yeah. Lenny Locascio.
Lenny Locascio.
From North Providence. And this is phenomenal.
Them.
And then, of course, because of all the beautiful, it is swordfish, but because of the fresh tomatoes, the Gaeta olives, all of the beauty in here, there's also a wonderful Tuscan Red I've selected, which is an $11 bottle. I featured it on the show before. It's a Banfi wine. It's Centenè. And it's beautiful.
Centenè.
It's not overpowering.
What does that mean, Centenè?
Centenè. It's like 100.
Ah, Centenè.
Yeah, it's part of that.
So the fallacy Centenè. Of drinking red wine with fish is a fallacy. It's a fallacy.
Throw that out the window.
You can absolutely drink red wine with fish,
you
especially.
Pair wine to the sauce, whatever you're eating, and that will always help.
Nice.
And another thing you can pair is you and someone that you love at the Post Office Cafe Terrace all summer long. You know, it is phenomenal out there.
Perfect it's for you.
The place to be and be seen. John Granata's Post Office Cafe. They got that beautiful terrace overlooking Main Street.
And you can enjoy a delicious dish like this in the comfort of your own home, too. And like you said, really affordable. You're making it easy. Everyone grab a fork and just dive into this.
Right.
Grab a couple bottles of wine, too.